Why I'm telling you this story? Because the king said to the prophet, I'm not sure that Hashem really gave me 15 more years to live. Can you give me a sign? He told him, today you see the sun? The sun will not go down on time today. You will see the day will be very long today. And then it's supposed to be dark at 8, 10 o'clock, you still have light. All the people in Iraq, Babylon, Nebuchadnezzar, they saw, wow, what happened today? The sun doesn't go down. So they decided to send someone on a horse all the way to Israel from Iraq to find out, maybe the Jews know in Beit HaMikdash, why the sun did not go down on today's date. So one person got on a horse, is ready to go, and the Nebuchadnezzar, the midget, was very wicked. He said, wait a minute, why did you write in a letter to the people of, to the king of Israel, to the people of Jerusalem, to the people of Israel, and to their God? Why you put God in the end of the sentence? You should start for the honor of the God of Israel, and for the king of Israel, and for the people of Jerusalem, and for the people of Israel. That's the right order. So he got up from his chair. He walked 3 steps. 1, 2, 3. He took the ladder and he fixed it. For these 3 letters, the Gemara say, Hashem gave him 60 years control in the world. He was a king 43 years. And his son, grandson 2 years. All together, if I remember correctly, about 60 years of control he had in the world. Why was that? For 3 steps that he made. That's why when we pray Shmona Esrei, we go 3 steps in the back. Reverse. Why? And right after that, we say, Yiratzon Shibane Bet HaMikdash, that the temple will be built, because he destroyed Bet HaMikdash. He made 3 steps forward, and Hashem gave him so much power, and he destroyed Bet HaMikdash. We go reverse, 3 steps, we take our head down, we surrender, that Bet HaMikdash will be built, because of what happened with him. But from here we learn, if a goy like this, that was like Hitler, Russia, he made 3 steps to respect Hashem. Very big murderer, but he respect God. 3 steps only. Well, he got up from his chair, 1, 2, 3. And he was 43 years, he was a king himself, before his son and his grandson. 43 years. So, you know, so the point is that after we see such a thing, if somebody like him got so many years of power that he controlled the whole world, for 3 steps, we walk to the synagogue 1,000 steps. How many words Hashem owe us to each one of us every Shabbat? The Gemara say, you see from here that the real reward is not in this world, because you cannot share this whole world to all the Jews. Every Jew deserves thousands of words just from his mitzvot. So the reward is not over here. Over here it's a temporary life, a blink of the eye and life is over. To the life of eternity, when the soul comes out of the body, that's when the soul will receive an eternal reward. And the same thing, it's written in the book of Kohelet, chapter 7, verse 14. Gam et ze leumat ze asa Elokim. Hashem always gave balance in the world, 50-50. 50% you can go to this side, 50% you can go to the opposite. It's always balance. You hear a good speech, right the way as someone that is hating Torah and an atheist will brainwash you to balance it. There's always going to be a doubt. It's not going to be so clear, because then everyone will be religious. No matter what, you see a miracle, right the way something happened, that you begin to question your belief. This is how it is. Hashem gave Moshe, he gave Bilam for the Goyim. Moshe threw the cane on the floor, it became a snake. The Egyptians, the biggest Reshaim, they take the stick, they throw it, it became snakes. What is this? Why? Not to ruin the free choice. It has to be a free will. So it says like this. Kechol shekoach hakdusha gadol, the more holiness you have in the world, the same thing on the other side you have impurity, tum'a. When the desire to Hashem was burning, to come and be close to Hashem, and we had prophets in those days, at the same time the Avodah Zarah, the idols, also made magics. People used to go to some kind of an idol worshiper. My son is dying, do something. He says all kinds of things. He makes fire. He makes spices. Big statue. 2 hours later, the boy ran in the neighborhood. It's a very big test. Hashem said, don't go to the idols. It's a very big sin. With all due respect, I don't want my son to die. My friend went there and he helped him. I also go. It was mamash even. Even if you go to a big chacham, it helps. You go to an idol, it also helps. So it says like this. It was so strong, the Avodah Zarah, that the chachamim wanted to cancel it from the world. We don't want it. So the chachamim say to Hashem, Hashem say, I cannot cancel it. Because then you're going to have only the prophecy. I need prophecy and I need idol Kohanim of Avodah Zarah. If I cancel one side, I have to cancel the other side. And the Chachamim say, do it. Cancel the prophecy. We don't need any more prophets. Cancel the Avodah Zarah. It makes so much damage, better we don't have prophets. And this is how the Nevuah stopped. 2,000 years ago, after the destruction of the Second Temple, no more prophets. No more prophets. Why? Because Hashem had to cancel the Avodah Zarah, he also canceled the Nevuah. So, what do you see from here? The test will always be equal. You can choose. In the end, after everything you hear, it makes a lot of sense, but you have a lot of desires, and you see that when you steal, you make millions, and it's not so simple like the rabbi said, that everyone pays in the end. How do I know it's going to happen to me? Hashem always creates a dilemma. He creates 100% a doubt in your mind in order for you to, you know, to still have a test. Otherwise, there's no, you don't deserve a reward. If it's so clear, you don't have a reward. Now,